Hello. My name is Lauren Gold. I am a PhD student working under Dr. Robert Lee Kamwa in the School of Arts, Media, and Engineering at Arizona State University. Augmented reality and virtual reality are enabling us to do superhuman things. It's allowing us first-person perspectives that are not humanly possible. Powered by data collected by remote instruments, this technology is enabling us to do fieldwork anywhere, at any time. And with recent advances, we're able to share these immersive experiences with our colleagues. Today, I am excited to present to you the JMARS Extended Reality Platform. Our source data is from JMARS, a planetary GIS that has supported planetary missions and science analysis over the past decade. And JMARS contains planetary data for almost any body that you could imagine. Using JMARS, you can prepare terrain scenes and export them for use in our XR platform, meaning they can be viewed in augmented reality and virtual reality. Preparing a terrain scene consists of a few components, but it can be as simple or as complex as you would like it to be. You can choose from a plethora of data sets that JMARS provides and add an assortment of layers like I have here, or you could just export the 3D terrain geometry by itself with no data layers. Okay. You can even choose the spawn point for which you would like your VR experience to start. And today I would like to walk you through how you would create a VR experience and share it with your colleagues using our JMARS XR platform. So say I'm a researcher studying Granite Wash, Arizona, and that's what we're looking at here in the JMARS app. And I've added the TIM stamp, the thermal imaging spectrometer data layer. And this layer will show me a decorrelation stretch, making clear the geologic differences across the terrain, marked in different colors. And I may want to take a look at this in the JMARS 3D viewer. And once I do that, I may start to recognize a pattern that the lower elevation rocks are all in the same classified unit, marked in red color. And I may suspect that rocks in this unit are all of the same color and texture. But I would really have to be there in Granite Wash, Arizona to know that for sure. So I will export this to our XR platform for a more immersive view. And upon doing so, I will be given a VR room code so that I can send that room code to my colleagues who are remote, and they can join me inside of the VR experience to look at this Granite Wash scene. So here are my remote colleagues. We have Olivia, the blue avatar, and Augustine, the pink avatar. And we're all now in this Granite Wash scene that you were just looking at in the 3D viewer inside of this immersive experience. So we're going over to that area with the lower elevation rocks. And I have my JMARS data layers in here. So I can pull that up, and I can even turn off the TIMS layer so that I can look at the terrain by itself. Here we go, turning off the TIMS layer. So there's just the plain terrain scene again. Now from this vantage point, I can make a more confident decision about what that area really consists of. And my colleagues can also give me their diagnosis. So Olivia has a VR headset at home, so she's going to jump into VR. And Augustine has an iPad, so he will look at the same scene in augmented reality. And they'll let me know what they think. So through this experience, I was able to communicate to my colleagues the geologic patterns that I was noticing, and they were able to clearly see that because we were there together. Now, what if you wanted to share this immersive experience with more people? Or maybe you want to add a terrain scene to your AGU poster. Well, it's actually pretty easy because JMARS will generate a QR code for you. That QR code will always link to your terrain scene. So you could paste the QR code on your AGU poster, and people walking by could scan the QR code and look at your data in augmented reality. In fact, if you scan this QR code over here on the side, it will take you to a download page where you can find each one of our XR apps and instructions on how to prepare your own terrain scenes. Today, I shared with you one example of an immersive data story that my team has come up with for Granite Wash, Arizona. But we're very excited to see the immersive stories that you all come up with for your own data. This was all made possible through our collaboration with the JMARS team, our subject matter experts, Dr. Catherine Powell and Dr. Jonathan Hill, and our ASU student developers. Also, thank you to the AGU Hyperwall team for letting me present today. And thank you all for coming to the talk. We are giving VR demos all week over at the ASU booth right there, so please stop by. Thank you.